Good morning. Today is Monday. Feeling a little tired from cookies this weekend, a little too much sugar. Today, my usual clinic was canceled due to COVID. It's gonna all be telemed. I'm gonna be on standby if any of the patients need help sending home monitor transmissions. Home monitors have been the most helpful for telemed because we can get a manual interrogation from the pacemaker this morning and use that as a guide for the patient's visit with the doctor. I'm having a little bit of sinus congestion, so really trying to get that lymphatic drainage going this morning. And then I also signed up for a COVID test tomorrow morning. It's a drive-through system, very easy in Arizona. I'm getting weekly tested for credentialing in one of our ASC private surgery centers.
I'm experiencing no symptoms, nor have I had any this summer. Prior to Thanksgiving, I was getting tested every 2 weeks, and now I'm getting tested every week until after New Year's Eve. This is to confirm that it is a COVID-free implanting center at one of our private surgery centers. This is the doctor's decision, and as our customer, we have to respect his vendoring credentials. Also, I rub my face so much because of the Skinny Confidential podcast.
All my Grey's Anatomy scrubs, my ninja scrubs, I usually don't get questioned when I enter the hospital. They just make me look official, I suppose. But they have a nice flared bottom and a cinched waist. I always think a V-neck is very flattering for women too.
Tis the season for advent calendars. I missed yesterday, so I get two chocolates later. That's exciting. I am packing up my planner that has my top three things I need to do today, my notepad where I keep ongoing notes, my laptop, and then my secret weapon, which is my clipboard. I pack my lunch because I don't want to rely on eating hospital food or eating out. I also am a big snacker. I mentioned in another video that I'm known as the bag lady to my boyfriend. Okay. It's because I'm always leaving my apartment with a bag. My first stop is headed to a hospital to deliver the return boxes that I made. I will make a note to look at the scheduling board to see if anything has changed and there's any add-ons. It's a good opportunity. Let's check the gas. May have to do a Costco stop later.
Very self-aware of my PPE, hand sanitizer in my car. If your hand sanitizer is frozen during this time of the year, it is not good. It means it doesn't have true alcohol in it, so I would throw it away. Make sure you're using good products to stay safe.
All right, it's a quiet morning on the text string. So I'm gonna go knock out a FedEx project. We got a new PA at one of the clinics. So I'm gonna make her an introductory device fundamentals binder.
Definitely the largest crack to date. It goes all the way across my windshield. Thankfully it's low and not in my line of sight. I've gotten a new windshield every year so far. This windshield is from January and it's December. So I'm probably gonna get a new one in January. One of the hardest things being in the field is responsiveness because I'm not sitting at a laptop during the day. I am actually in the field, actively driving, actively helping patients in the hospital, not a predictable schedule. So when emails do roll through, I really try to answer them right on spot. One came through from my manager. It was about a specific account. He has a meeting tomorrow. So I want to be the super clinical and respond appropriately.
And just like that, the schedule got turned around. A patient showed up in clinic unexpected and I was closest. So I headed out and went and checked the patient who was Spanish speaking only.
So my mom thinks I was sent to Arizona because I studied Spanish in college and practiced it all throughout high school. In no way am I perfect. I sound like a gringa, but I always try and I have a pretty good strong vocabulary. When I forget my verbs, my sentences go a little astray, but sometimes my brain is on it. So I just helped a patient that was Spanish speaking only, and I'm thankful that I got to check them. Some keywords. El macapaso, that is pacemaker. You can also use diviso, el diviso. My other go-to is todos los números se miran muy bien. Usted tiene mucha batería.
English translation, all the numbers look good and you have a lot of battery left. I'm running on E, so I'm stopping at Costco before my afternoon clinic at 1 o'clock. I like to treat Costco like it's my office, and I max out the cash back that Costco offers on their MasterCard. The best part is at the end of the year when you get the cash back in gift cards to just use again at Costco. I had a really successful clinic. I helped teach device fundamentals to the MA, upgraded the computer, checked 4 patients, spoke more Spanish. Here I am arriving early for my next case. It is a biventricular pacemaker. The patient has heart failure.
Feeling cute and hydrated until get to a point in the case, preparing, realize we don't have the one thing needed to test the wires, the adapter. Oh, and that's right. I am running in full lead, so I get very warm when I get back to the cath lab. Had a good case, learned about atrial clips. We'll talk about that in a moment. That dang adapter. I replied to my messages and putting off thinking about work to cook some dinner. I love to make Dutch oven recipes. I try to do a new one every week. This is a short rib recipe. I'm feeling really good about tonight's Dutch oven recipe. I give it an 8.5 out of 10 just because it required a little bit more cleaning than I would have liked at the end, but really good, good flavor, easy to cut. I'm meal prep for the week. I'm writing down the top 3 things I wanna do tomorrow. I missed one of the things today, so I'm just gonna cycle it over to the next day. And then today I saw something new. So during today's biventricular pacemaker implant, the patient had previous open heart. Another term for that is CABG. He had sternal wires down his chest, and they gave him an AtriClip or an AtriClip. According to Google, an AtriClip is applied to the outside surface of the left atrial appendage. This is what I refer to as kind of the dog ear. When you're doing a heart dissection, it's easy to see. So to me, it looks like a hairpin, and understanding how it's placed by the cardiothoracic surgeon makes sense. It's placed externally to cut off that appendage dog ear. Compared to non-invasively placing an ambulant or watchman through the venous system into the appendage from the inside. You know, I'd never heard of an AtriClip, so this is pretty cool. Next time I see a hairpin with 2 little loops on the end, I will know it is an AtriClip. Final stats for the day. Pretty low average of 129 notifications. And then this is a featured Modus Monday. This is not today, just a fun one. Thanks for tuning in, guys. I hope you keep watching.